Okay, guys, welcome to Wednesday morning. I'm here in Little Rock getting a load of tire chips, going down to South Arkansas. I just delivered, if you remember, last Thursday or Friday, I picked up a load of lightweight product, and I just delivered it nearby. You know, I was off for a few days, and I just delivered it over here, not far from here, and then called in. They sent me a load picking up here, which is just a few, probably not even 2 miles away. And so got this load, which is good. I was a little worried it might take a while because freight's been slow. And Manuel, my dispatcher, said that after I make this delivery down in South Arkansas, he's already got me a load picking up some, I think it's called headlap roofing material that goes down to Texas. So that ought to work. That ought to work. So yeah, it's gonna be a nice hot August day. Just getting started here. Had some work going on my truck while I was off over the good folks over at Quality Truck Repair in North Little Rock. I got my my half fender right there reinstalled. Remember I showed you that got blown off, and they put 4 new shocks on my drive axles. See if I can show you one of them. There's one of them right there. And I got a new lines here, new electrical and air lines, and a pogo stick here. Got that put in, and I got a PM, you know, oil filter change, all that. So anyway, getting loaded.
Ladies and gentlemen, so it's Wednesday afternoon, about 2:40. Let me update you because I really haven't filmed much, if anything. But I think I showed you a little bit of me getting that load of tire chips at there in Little Rock. And boy, look at this truck creeping up the hill. He must be loaded. Anyway, I delivered that down to South Arkansas a couple hours ago, and Manuel, my dispatcher, sent me to Glenwood, Arkansas. I'm about 20 minutes away, just giving you some road footage. It's a good hot August day, and I'll be picking up some roofing material that'll go down to Ennis, Texas. It's a run I've done before. That's why I hadn't filmed much today, because every place I've been is a place I've filmed from multiple times before. So just decided to give it a break. Well, we got some, what do we call this? Southwest Arkansas, Central Western Arkansas footage here. I don't know how long this place loads. I'm thinking 4 o'clock, but I'll be there around 3, maybe a few minutes past 3. So it should be okay for getting loaded. It's usually a pretty quick load. You know, you pull under a chute. It's kind of like roofing granules. Tell them how much you want, they put it in, steal out. Anyway, that's what we're doing. I think this little town is called Kirby. Daisy State Park to the left. Okay. to, I've come, usually when I come through here, I'm coming from the that other direction over there, is what I was pausing for. Anyway, just giving you some road footage. Kind of a slow ride from where I was to get up here, you know, just two-lane country roads. And it'll take me a couple hours to get out of here, back to the freeway and head toward Texas. That's a good trip. And my dispatcher, Manuel, when he gave me this order, he asked me about the weekend. Got the Labor Day weekend coming up, and I said, I'm okay with getting home Friday or Saturday, and I'm okay with leaving out and driving Monday, delivering on Tuesday. That's really what he wanted to know, was I okay to leave out with a load and get it delivered Tuesday? And I was like, yes, yes, because I just came off back today from being off for, 4 days, I guess, five days. Yeah, I need to get back to work. Okay, enough talking. Okay, y'all, I'm in the loading position. Scale is over there on that side. Then you come up through here, get into the loading position. I'll give you a shot. Just watching my scales, but I weighed about 31,600. I told him I'd take 24 tons because I'm in good shape on fuel. But that's it. It's called head lap. It's the stuff they put on the head of the roofing shingle. You know, not the roofing granules, but the part that tucks up under the other shingles, and you nail it. That's my understanding anyway. So that's what we got. I'm a little bit front of center, so I'll let it pile up there, watch my scale, and then pull up a little and get the next pile going a little bit back of center. All right, boys and girls, welcome to Thursday morning. It's a little before 7 a.m. We're trying to, we're on the outskirts of Dallas. About to cross over this lake here, which I forget the name of the lake, but I think it's the water supply for Dallas. You know, we're about 9 miles from the exit to 635, which is what I'm gonna take and kind of skirt around the eastern edge of Dallas, get down to 45, heading to Ennis. Just giving you a morning shot of some road footage. Dallas traffic, I tell you, Dallas is one of the, as far as traffic goes, one of the worst I've experienced as far as bigger cities. It's like there's so many freeways that go in and out of Dallas. It can be pretty wicked. Coming up here on the right, which disregards my turn signal. I'm going to refrain from commenting on Dallas area drivers. Anyway, 82 degrees at the moment, going to be another hot one. Got a lot of road construction around here. Working on the, I don't know, I think they're expanding the bridge here. So anyway, I've got this load of head lap, they call it, roofing product. to Ennis, Texas. I don't know what's after that. But you know, I'm, depending on traffic, I'm still about 45 minutes away, so it'll be about 7:45 maybe before I get there. And I've delivered to this place at least once, maybe twice. And it just kind of depends on if there's anybody in front of you. As I remember, we'll be, you know, backing up and just kind of dumping into a underground pit. The unload doesn't take that long. It just, the time or two I've been here before, there was a couple of trucks in front of me. Well, actually, the first time I came here, their equipment, their conveyor equipment had broken down. We had to wait several hours to even be able to unload. And then I think the second time, maybe, there was, yeah, there was a couple of trucks in front of me, so it just depends. Anyway, that's a shot of the morning here in Texas. All right, folks, here I am, arriving at my customer. I've already scaled in, the guy signed my paperwork. I just stopped there and rolled my tarp off and moved my mud flaps. Getting ready for unloading. The fella at the scale house told me to come back here. I've been here before, so I knew where to go. But I'm supposed to get back here and ask for a fella named Jason. You can see right in front of me, about 10 yards ahead, that's the pit we're gonna be dumping into. I have not seen anybody, so I'm just kind of pulling in to get in a general position here, and then I'll try to find Jason. One thing I do remember is it's a real tight spot to turn around back here to head out of here. I see some guys over here to the left. I don't know if they're just part of a construction crew or if they work here. Anyway, we're pulling forward. You can see how tight the turnaround spot is here. Real tight. All right, let me try to find Jason. Okay guys, so I found Jason and he went to kind of get his equipment set up properly, but you can see I'm in the unload position. So when we're done, you just gotta make a sharp turn out of here. I'm not looking forward to that. And then go back out that way. So let's take a look at this. As you can see, I don't have the trailer raised up. We're not unloading yet. I'm just waiting on Jason to get ready for the unload. But I'll show you the setup here. So what we're gonna do here, you know, they've got an underground pit here that conveys products up into their facility there. So what we'll do is as the trailer raises up, we're just gonna raise this little door right here and it'll slowly fall into this grate. But there's the product, if you remember, headlap. Goes on to the top part of roofing shingles. Not the actual roofing granules, but the part that just goes on the top, you know, the top part where you stick it under the previous shingle and nail to it. All right, well, just waiting on Jason to come back. All right, guys, just wanted to give you a quick glimpse of the unload now that product's coming out. Got another truck back there waiting to unload, but
It's just been dumping out here for a couple of minutes, so still got a lot to go, but that's what it looks like. It's slowly coming out the back. You can see the product shift as it unloads. But that's how it works. This will probably take about 30 or 40 minutes. I'll speak to the Carl Manuel, my dispatcher, and see if he's got my next load.
All right, people, update for you. It's about 9:40 Thursday morning. Made that delivery back there in Ennis, Texas. You can see Dallas off into the distance there to the left a little bit. We're on 45 North, got to go through Dallas. And my next load is picking up in Durant, Oklahoma. Be a load of metal shred that I'll be taking back to North Little Rock. And then my dispatcher, Manuel, really on his toes today. He said after that, we're gonna pick up a load going up to East Alton, Illinois for Tuesday's delivery. So, pretty sure I know where that's gonna be, but I won't say. And this load I pick up in Durant, Oklahoma, here in a couple hours. I'll deliver it tomorrow morning. I won't be able to get there today. Let me turn my CB on. Won't be able to get there today before they stop receiving. That's okay, that's okay. I can deliver it first thing in the morning, and then the place I'm gonna be picking up is like half an hour away. Oh, we're starting to get some traffic. Lo and behold, who'd have thunk it? Those guys, the two guys back there that were helping me unload in Ennis, they were asking me, what's your least favorite and your most favorite cities to drive through? I was like, huh, I don't really have a favorite, but I said, Dallas has got to be at the top or close to it as far as least favorite. There's just so much traffic, so many roads in and out of Dallas. I don't know. So much traffic. And then I said, St. Louis, for some reason. I don't know if I'm just lucky or if it's their road designs through St. Louis, but I rarely get clogged up trying to get around or through St. Louis. So there you go, St. Louis. Good job, you won something. So yeah, you know, it's 9:45 in the morning, and I was thinking I'd probably miss a lot of the morning rush, and I probably am, but as you can see, there's still plenty of it to go around. So we've got to go through Dallas here, and then we're gonna hop on to 75 North up toward Oklahoma, and then Durant is just there in southern Oklahoma. And then from there, we'll cut across on 70 into Arkansas, over to I-30, and then over to Little Rock. Just giving you some road footage here. Big D, going through the Big D. And I do mean Dallas. Okay, well that's enough of that. Okay, let's go ahead and give you a shot of downtown Dallas.